got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite when they're coming to take your freedom.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth, and a special shout-out to the likers and soon-to-be likers of the 420 Occupy New Hampshire Marijuana Legalization page, which I am one of the newest content creators for, and I'll be pushing along. Hello to you too, Maggie Hassan, or whichever one of your little constituents you have watch this. If you bother. I don't know how much you care. Evidently not a lot. Anyway, I wanted to bring to you the New Hampshire pot news. This isn't enough, people. This is absolute bullshit. I'm going to read you the post from Normal. I'll link you to it. Link you to the page I just showed you on Facebook. If you're a Facebooker and in New Hampshire, please get on that page, like it, share it. I'll be working really hard to gather people together to take action. This medical marijuana bill is watered-down bullshit, and I see it no good in many ways, which I'm going to explain to you either along the way through reading this. If I can contain myself, I'll wait till the end. New Hampshire House and Senate agree on compromise medical marijuana measure Wednesday the 19th. House and Senate negotiators on Tuesday, June 18th, agreed on a final version of House Bill 573, which allows for a regulated system of medical cannabis distribution in New Hampshire. The amended bill establishes the creation of four state-sanctioned marijuana dispensing facilities to produce and distribute cannabis to state-qualified patients who possess a physician's recommendation. Patients would be allowed to legally possess no more than 2 ounces of cannabis. Patients must obtain cannabis only from a state-licensed facility. Patients will not be provided with any legal protections to possess or use cannabis prior to the establishment of such facilities. As originally passed by the House, the measure allowed for qualified patients to have the option to grow their own cannabis. The measure also allowed for physicians to recommend cannabis for the treatment of post-traumatic stress. Both provisions were stripped from the bill by the Senate. Newly elected Democrat Governor Maggie Hassan, who pushes for the Senate's changes to the bill, is expected to approve HB 573. The commission is expected to be put in place to oversee the implementation of the law as soon as the bill's passed. Thank you, Normal, for the information. For all you legislators, senators, you, Maggie Hassan, this is absolute bullshit. For the rest of you that want me to explain what is bullshit about this, first of all, we're talking about one nation under God. God gave to man all seed-bearing plants. I shouldn't have to discuss a damn thing any further. The science says of the health benefits, even if it's not terminal cases, folks, okay, for 150 different treatments, okay. The way I see this is that the only way you're going to be fucking allowed to do something is if we monopolize it and we profit from it. And if we don't like you or we decide for whatever reason that you can't have what we have, you're not going to get it. We'll throw you in jail if you do. Absolute bullshit. New Hampshire motto, live free or die, is a fucking fallacy and a blatant lie. If everybody of adult age can't possess this plant, okay, yes, it does need to be regulated in for the children and whatnot. But you sling your fucking alcohol on both of the major highways coming in and out of the state. Around 75 feet from the highway are what you call safety rest stops. And there's only three fucking things you can do there. Use the restroom or buy hard liquor and lottery. Yeah! Right beside the highway. The two most addictive things known to man. Sell it to you. They love it. You can't have this plant. Fuck you. I will not comply with your written, wasted verbiage. Okay? The law. And I want to remind everybody something, too. First of all, for those of you that get caught with it, push it to jury trial. For those of you that are sitting on jury trials on marijuana-related cases, you must remember that if a law is unjust, you must acquit. If it violates human rights, you must acquit. This law violates human rights. Any law against full possession of marijuana by an adult violates human rights. Period. You must acquit. You must. That's a juror's right. Ask, I'm sorry, I forget the gentleman's name. That was just arrested and served time for informing jurors of that. But that's true. That's a fact. Research it. Okay? This is absolute bullshit. I see this as a ploy from Maggie Hassan to win the marijuana vote because everybody knew she was going to back the medical marijuana law. In my experience, after living for about a year in California and see what it had done out there, crime rates and stuff didn't go up. Absolutely not. It didn't stop or increase any marijuana trade that I saw. So that's irrelevant. But what I did see is that a few were able to profit from the system, and many were still restricted. And when the time came that the people saw fit that it should be legalized across the board, the advocates for the legalization on the medical side turned against everybody that wanted to be able to use it in the way they saw fit. And the bill died. It didn't go through. So this, a lot of people see as a step in the right direction. I see it as a deception and useless. And I will not comply with this law. Okay? I will possess and use cannabis when and where I see fit, in respect to the people around me, so that anybody that's offended by it won't be harmed. It won't blow hits in your face, in other words, and I won't smoke it in your presence if I know that you're against it. That's respect for my fellow man. That's the law I follow. I don't need it written down on paper, nor will I comply with what's on paper. And Maggie Hassan, you should expect us. As this group grows, we will be demanding that you meet with us publicly to debate all the aspects of marijuana, whether it be religious, scientific, health, however, all. Be prepared for all the aspects, the economics, okay? Because I've had enough of the bullshit, and I'm not going to be criminalized, nor am I going to allow my fellow man to be criminalized for owning a plant when we have somebody who can't even prove his identity or is unwilling to, at the very least, running this entire country, bombing the shit out of everybody that he chooses to, with drones or whatever other means he decides, and sending the Secret Service to people's houses who speak out against them. No, I will not comply. I'm asking you not to comply. I'm asking you to mirror this video so that it can reach as many people in New Hampshire as possible. And with that, I'll leave you. That's the news of the day. Much love. Many thanks. And again, to the creators of this page, thanks for letting me jump on board and help further the movement. I'll try to give it as much attention as I can. Much love, many thanks. Folks, both links will be below. One to the normal blog. Subscribe to their email alerts. You can get information about your state. And if you don't really have the facts about marijuana, feel free to email me, kevin@masterofmanythings.com. No question is stupid. I won't be insulted by anything. If you just want to know more, I'm happy to fill you in. So anyway, that's enough for now. I've babbled on long enough. I'll see you on the next one.